Seat the retainer tightly in the receiver. Next, the stock group is assembled to the receiver group. The machine screw is then inserted in the bottom of the stock. Tighten it securely with the combination wrench. Join the barrel group to the receiver group. And lastly, replace the fore-end assembly by engaging the recess of the fore-end on the cocking arm and sight base lug. Now secure the machine screw with the combination tool. The M79 grenade launcher, a manually operated weapon, has few moving parts. The safety may be operated manually. Moving the safety to the rear places the launcher in the safe position. The letter S will show in front of the safety on the receiver. When moved forward, it is in the firing position. The letter F will show on the receiver directly behind the safety. However, when the barrel locking latch is operated to open the breech, an actuator contacts the safety if it is in firing position and moves it rearward to the safe position. To load the launcher, point the muzzle in a safe area clear of all personnel. Move the barrel locking latch fully to the right and break open the breech. Insert the projectile into the chamber opening and push the round forward until the extractor contacts the rim of the cartridge case. Then close the breech. This frees the spring-loaded latch, which pivots and locks the barrel to the receiver. By moving the safety to the F position, the weapon is ready to fire. Squeezing the trigger causes the sear to release the hammer, which then strikes the firing pin. To show the working mechanism of the M79 grenade launcher, this model will be used. Parts involved in the trigger and sear action include the sear, the sear nose, the sear notch, the hammer spring, and the firing pin. The rear of the trigger lifts the rear of the sear, causing the nose of the sear to become disengaged from the sear notch in the hammer. The hammer, driven forward by the hammer spring, strikes the firing pin against the primer of the cartridge. It retracts slightly, allowing the firing pin to be withdrawn from the primer. The parts involved during unlocking are the barrel locking lever, the actuator and spring, safety bar and safety. Unlocking is accomplished by pressing the barrel locking lever to the right. This unlocks the barrel, and at the same time, the actuator pushes the safety to the safe position. Looking at the model from the left side, the weapon is cocked through the action of the cocking arm and cocking lever. This is actuated when the barrel is opened. As the barrel pivots downward, the cocking arm lifts the cocking lever. This causes it to rotate around the hammer pin and to contact the boss on the hammer. The action rotates the hammer about the hammer pin until the sear notch is engaged by the sear. The hammer is now in the cocked position. Extraction takes place when the breech is broken open. As the barrel pivots, the extractor automatically withdraws the cartridge case 1/2 inch from the chamber, allowing you to remove it by hand. Breaking open the breech also cocks the weapon for the next firing. This completes the functioning of the M79 grenade launcher. In summary, the M79 grenade launcher is a shoulder type, single shot, break open, percussion fired weapon that breaks down for cleaning and maintenance into 4 major groups. The stock group, the barrel group, the receiver group, and the fore end assembly. The launcher fires a 40mm HE fragmentation projectile at ranges from 50 to 400 meters. It is capable of covering an area that previously had been inadequately protected by fragmentation projectiles against enemy ground forces, thus making it possible for subordinate elements to accomplish their assigned missions with greater effect and rapidity.